Hi YouTube family!
My name is Alicia English.
And I'm Philip English.
Welcome back to our channel.
We are on day three of this amazing mudroom transformation, and today is the day Alicia's idea comes to life.
I'm so excited. After a lot of prep work, we are finally getting to the part of this project where I actually get to bring my vision to life and get the design on the cabinetry, build the bench, get that dog door in, and really see all of the purposeful aspects we want to add to this space really get in here. And so I'm really, really excited. We're going to use all upcycled materials for this project. We actually haven't spent anything to do this entire renovation other than purchasing a dog door kit from Home Hardware.
Right.
So if you're looking for one like the one we got for Basset Hounds or whatever kind of furry friend you have, head to homehardware.ca. This is not a sponsored video, but this door is going to be a game changer for us. And we just thought we'd share the love and let you know where we got it. Right now, the girls are super confused because we have blocked their hole doing the drywall where yesterday it was open. So today we're gonna cut it back out, get the kit installed for them, and they're gonna have a blast running in and out. We are going to get cutting now and get this design on the cabinetry.
As per the vision, we're gonna use these straps as the vertical shiplap throughout the design. For the doors, these are too thick for the doors. Instead of using this, we're gonna mimic it with this 1/4-inch ply, and we're gonna rip these to the same dimensions and width as these strappings.
Perfect. Let's do it. Occasionally, I need a break. Stop me for a second, I got needs. Occasionally, I set them free. Don't only pay. So we've already cut all of our strips to be able to do the cabinet design, and so we have a whole pile of strips. Problem is, not all of our strips for the 4-foot height of the boards that we had are tall enough. So we are left with a little bit of shortage on this one particular spot on the front here. So we're going to line up at the top. We're gonna make the bottom seamless just with a little bit of putty on each of these slats. You are not going to tell. We're gonna make it look like it was just one solid piece. So the first thing I'm gonna do is use some Gorilla Glue, and I'm going to put the wood glue all the way down on my strap, putting it on. Then I'm going to use some brad nails. That's gonna help hold it nice and tight so the glue can dry really, really well. And then if we do have any indents from the brad nailer, I've turned my compression way down, but what we're gonna do is we'll just do a little putty mark before we paint this, because we are going to make this cabinetry a color. We are not gonna paint it white for a dog room, so we are going to choose a color to paint it. Making moves, trying to get away from this life I'm living. Same old things every day, wanna change this feeling. Wasting all my time. I do have some glue coming out on the sides, and I do need to do some sanding here, but it's easier to finish this off at the end. So I'm just gonna let it drip, I'm gonna let it do its thing, get this on there nice and solid. So I'm working my way down slowly, following the edge of the cabinet and just adding a few brad nails. Very, very tiny gap. Just enough to get a blade through to make sure no paint goops in between, but not enough to see anything behind. Making moves, trying to get away from this life I'm living. Same old things every day. Phase one of the bottom of the door is almost done. I just have to do the small pieces at the bottom, and my vision is already coming to life. I can already see how this wood is going to really accomplish the look that I'm looking for. So I'm pretty excited right now. Can you tell I'm super excited? Okay, so I left a tiny little gap, glued it, brad nailed it. I really, really thought that this tiny space was imperative for me to be able to get the look that I wanted. If I butted them up super close together and then painted it, it would just look like a solid piece. And I'm looking for that dimension on the front of the cabinets to make it look more custom. And then I'm gonna add my upcycled hardware that I'm going to make out of leather straps, which is going to look amazing against the color that I'm going to do. So I'm gonna work on the top, I'm gonna work on the sides, and I'm gonna finish up this bottom, and then I'll update you on what it looks like before I start building my bench.
Before we go inside and show you the progress that Alicia and I have been making, I'm gonna cut this dog door out the best I possibly can with this template, and then try and piece in the dog door.
We're gonna have to know where the height of the dog door is to know where our bench height's gonna go, so that's why we're doing this step now, right?
Yeah.
Good luck with that cut. Better you than me. I can see you coming through the other side. I'm way back. Hi, babe.
Hi, hon. Hi, YouTube family.
You need a bigger dog door than that.
Can I fit through here?
Fat basset. We have the dog door installed, and we are ready to start putting our bench on. And so I'm just creating some bracing at the back
to be able to start finishing this cabinetry and building the bench all the way across the bottom of this room. This is going to look amazing, and we're going to put some cute little steps here for the dogs to get outside this mudroom. But what we need to do before I actually adhere this on is to use a scrap piece of wood that's the same thickness as what my topper for my bench is going to be to ensure that I'm going to put this at the right height for my dog door space. So this is just a scrap piece, it's the same. And then that is where the height of my bench is going to go. So I'm pretty happy with that. What do you think, Philly?
I think that looks amazing.
We know that we have lots of room to give just in case we need to make any minor adjustments for leveling. I'm going to get this back bracing on, and then I'm going to start creating my box. Basically making a long rectangular prism, and I'm going to put a whole bunch of supports in it, and then I'm going to face the front of it and be able to do that same vertical shiplap across the front. Then I get to do the fun part of adding color and putting on my upcycled handles with the leather straps. I just finished building the base for my bench. I used completely scrap pieces. Some of them we had to rip to size, some of them I had to really cut down. It worked out perfectly, so the wood doesn't look glamorous, but it is going to be completely hidden with the top, and my vertical shiplap is going to go all the way across the front. And so I made sure to have lots of stability on this in case the dogs want to lay up on here or if someone sits on it. I didn't want it to just be decor, I wanted to actually function. So we made sure it was nice and strong. Dog door's in, cabinet design is ready to be prepped and painted on here. So I want to get this design all along the front here so I can get painting this whole space. I've been feeling so small. Watch the clock ticking off the wall. But tonight I'm letting it go. Spend my coin for show. I'm gonna be myself, or I could be someone. I just got all the vertical shiplap onto my bench base and it looks really crummy. It looks terrible, but I've used all scrap and I know that it's not going to stay looking like this, so be kind in the comment section. So right now all the slabs are on and they're all leveled to the spot that I want the top of the bench to go. I've just cut my pieces here for the top, so I'm hoping that this fits really well. This one's gonna go at the back. So it's a nice height with the pet door there, so I'm happy with that. I'm glad I pre-checked that before I cut all my wood. Here's my middle one, and then here. This one should go flush with the front if I did this right. Look at that, perfect. This wood here needs to come back out and get sanded completely down, stained and protected, because this is going to be a stained wood top. This bottom part here is going to be the same color as this cabinet here. So we tried to mimic the design of the 3-inch slats here and here. So this is going to get sanded super smooth. So it's going to be smooth, smooth, smooth like this smooth plywood that we used. And then I'll be able to use my leather strapping to create some hardware. This is the final look on the color that we're going to do. I'm gonna show you what that looks like. So I went to the fabric store a couple of weeks ago and I was really shocked by how much money it would cost for a tiny piece of leather fabric. I didn't even care if it was real leather, I just wanted it to mimic that look for the handles of the hardware, and I thought, this is just silly, what am I doing here? So I went to the thrift store and I found a bag for $2.99, and it was the exact color of the leather strapping that I would want for my hardware. So because it had lots of handles, there's another piece of lots and lots of handles and a belt I even picked up in case I needed some extra. I know I have lots of fabric to be able to cut off of this. So I took some of the strapping and I'm going to cut it into some strips. I'm going to make hardware by creating a loop and then putting it on something similar to that, maybe cut a little bit smaller with a screw in there to create a little bit of a faux handle. This already has a nice thing to be able to open and shut it when this is all done painting, but I want the look and the appearance of having some hardware handles on the outside of what I'm going to do. And I've decided, thanks to your comment section yesterday, you guys all agreed with what I was already thinking. This is going to be the same green color that we have been using on some of the exterior projects. I think since this is an entryway, when you're naturally gonna come in from seeing the exterior of the house, adding the green into the space is going to help it flow into the rest of the house. So this is all going to be painted green.
And now for the big grand reveal. Not yet. Tomorrow you're gonna have to wait to see the grand reveal.
We were really hoping to reveal this whole mudroom transformation for you in tonight's episode. But we've done 3 days in a row of, I think, over 13 hours, both days of building.
What day is it?
And we're still not quite ready to reveal it. We need to do a lot more sanding and a lot more prep to these wood surfaces before I can even get the paint on. Philip and I are gonna work through the night and we're going to get this done to reveal this for you tomorrow. Tomorrow is somebody's special day. Philip's birthday is tomorrow.
What?
And I asked him what he wanted for his birthday and he said to do the mudroom reveal for his birthday tomorrow. So I guess we're leaving the reveal till tomorrow. We are so excited to get the paint rolled on this room to make it nice and fresh white and get the color of green that we chose for the actual cabinets, get the hardware installed, get some hooks and stuff on the wall. This is going to be amazing. So stay tuned for tomorrow. Before we end this video, I wanted to really thank everybody for the support of our channel. Our channel is growing so fast.
Yeah, it's awesome watching.
And we are so encouraged and motivated to make more content. Every time you guys like, comment, subscribe, leave us amazing emails and messages. So we just want to thank you guys so much for being the best YouTube family we could ever ask for.
You guys rock.
Yeah, it is because of you guys that we can do content like this and get to be home with our families and live this life that we are creating to live a life we love. So thank you so much from the bottom of our hearts. We love you. Stay tuned for Phil's birthday and the mudroom huge transformation tomorrow. We also have another gigantic home renovation project coming up next week. So we need to get this project finished up.
So leave me a happy birthday down in the comment section. Even though it's tomorrow, let's start it today and carry it on tomorrow.
We are waiting for some supplies to come in for the camper and we are also waiting for an inspection on the studio build. So for those of you who are waiting to see more on those series, we're not just jumping projects, we're waiting for things to be able to finish those. So we're not gonna sit around and wait. So we're working on some other content, but stay tuned. We have more of those coming. Soon as our inspection's done, we can get back into the studio for the interior. And when the camper supplies show up, we can finish that camper bathroom. Thank you guys for your support. We love you. See you tomorrow for Phil's birthday.
Woo!